It's a beautiful day for remote learning, a beautiful day for a lesson. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? It's a studently day in this beauty wood, a studently day for a lesson. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? I have always wanted to have a student just like you. I've always wanted to teach in a classroom with you. So let's make the most of this beautiful day. Since we're together, might as well say, would you be mine? Could you be mine? Won't you be my student? Won't you please? Won't you please? Please, won't you be my student?
Hi everyone, welcome back to Miss Nichols' Neighborhood. It's me, your teacher, Miss Nichols. I'm here with my best remote teacher helper, my sister, Kayla Nichols.
Hi.
Hi. We're excited because we are putting together all that we've been learning about subtraction and using it for problem solving.
Ooh.
It's where we might have to think just a little bit harder or maybe a little differently in order to solve some problems, okay? Specifically, we're going to use what we just learned about writing a number sentence to do problem solving here, okay? Just like you'll be seeing in your learning packets, okay, in your work, I'm going to go ahead, I'll read you the problem, and then I'll show you some ways that we could work together to solve it, okay? And I kind of cut it off, but I have my book right here to read from, so when I'm looking down, that's why, okay? But you just didn't need to see my messy setup right now. Okay. Our first problem-solving story. It says, my aunt has 8 quilt squares to sew on the quilt. She sews 6 squares. Write a number sentence to show how many squares are left to sew on the quilt.
Ooh, interesting.
And they've given me, well, I've given myself a lot of space here to use like manipulatives if you have tools or crayons you want to use at home to help you. But I'm also going to show you how you can draw out the problem, okay? Because hopefully I know we all have at least a pencil and paper with us to work on solving this, okay? Okay, let's read it again. Now this time we'll get to drawing. It says, my aunt has 8 quilt squares to sew on the quilt. She has 8 quilt squares. How many does she have? 8. Make sure you're listening, paying attention, okay? 8 quilt squares. I'm going to go ahead and draw 8 circles to represent or show those 8 quilt squares, okay? I'm going to count as I draw them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay? Again, how many quilt squares am I starting with?
8.
Yes, thank you, Kaylee. If you're paying attention at home, nice job. 8. So if that's how many I start with, I'm going to put that in the first spot of my subtraction number sentence. I start with 8 quilt squares. Okay? But then, my aunt sews 6 of those squares. She sews or uses 6 of these. Okay? So, does it sound like she's adding more squares to her quilt? Or that squares are being taken away because she's sewing them? They're going away, taking away. She's using them. So then, we're going to trace or write our minus sign to say, yep, she's using some of the squares, taken away. 8 minus or take away, she sews 6 squares. She sews 6 of them. How many of these does she sew? How many does she use? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 of them. So I'm going to go ahead and put an X or cross out 6 of those. She's used them. I'm going to count as I cross them out. Bye-bye to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yep. How many did she use?
6.
6. So we're going to say 8 squares take away 6. She's already used 6 of them. 8 take away 6. Now it looks like her answer is coming up. We're ready to say that 8 take away 6 is. Or 8 take away 6, what's this sign?
Equals.
Nice job, Kaylee. That's what you said at home too. Good job. So we'll trace or write equals. Now we're going to write how many squares does my aunt still have to sew? How many has she not sewn yet? How many does she still have? Okay, let's go ahead and double check by counting how many we still have left. Ready? You're going to count with me. Ready, set, count with me. 1, 2. Good. How many does she still have to sew?
2.
Nice job, if that's what you said at home as well. 2. Wow. That was a lot there. A lot of problem solving. I just jumped into it. I was like, let me show you. Let's go back and reread and double check our subtraction number sentence we wrote. Okay, you're going to read it with me. Ready, set, read with me. 8 take away 6 equals 2. Yep, my aunt had 8 squares to sew. I use little circles to show. Drawing a bunch of squares is hard, okay? 8 squares. Then she sewed 6 of them. She used 6 of them. So then we said she had 2 left. Wow. Right there, we were given a story problem. We were able to draw, to figure it out, and write a number sentence to solve it. Whew, that was a lot right there, okay? We're going to go ahead, we'll keep practicing this, because really I think you know how to do the subtraction, and it's just becoming more and more comfortable with using that subtraction for these story problems, okay? So give Kayla and I a few seconds to set up the next problem. Here we are back with our next problem solving story problem, okay? Just like in your learning packets you'll have at home, you're going to need a family member or someone else who's helping you with your learning read the story problem to you, okay? That's why I'm not bothering writing up all the words, because they're so small in your learning packets, and it does say for someone else to read them to you. So make sure you're listening very carefully when you're doing your learning packets and during this lesson video. Everyone ready?
Yeah.
Okay, here's our next problem. There are 9 toys. 4 are put on this shelf. Write a number sentence to show how many toys are left to put on the shelf. I'm going to read it again. There are 9 toys. 4 are put on the shelf. Write a number sentence to show how many toys are left to put on the shelf. Okay, let's go ahead, go back to the beginning. Use this space. We can draw out the problem. Or if you want to use like crowns or coins or other manipulatives or tools you have at home, great. But I just wanted to show you how you can also draw it out in case you don't have those things, okay? So, it starts with, there are 9 toys. How many toys do we start with?
9.
9, yes. So I'm going to go ahead and draw 9 circles to represent or show 9 toys. Let's go ahead and count out loud as I do them.
Yeah.
Ready, set, count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. How many toys are we starting with?
9.
9. So I'm going to write that over here. We start with 9 toys. 9. Okay. But some are being put on the shelf. Toys are being put away. So do I need to write the plus sign, like, oh, we're getting more toys? Or do I need to write the minus sign, the takeaway sign, to show that some of these toys are being taken away to the shelf? Is it plus or minus here? Minus or takeaway? Some toys are being taken away to be put on the shelf. So we'll write minus or takeaway, and it says 4 are put on the shelf. 4 toys get put away on the shelf. So let's go ahead, cross out, mark out those 4 toys that are going away. I'm going to count out loud as I do them. Let's count out loud together to keep track. Ready, set, count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4 toys put away. How many toys got put away?
4. 4,
yes. Nice job, Kaylee. If you're trying your best at home and listening too, and that's what you said, yes. So we'll write that 4 toys get put away. 9 toys take away, 4 toys put on the shelf. What's the next sign we need to write to show that our answer's coming up? That 9 take away 4 is. What's this sign?
Equals.
Yes, nice job, Kaylee. We write equals. Now we need to count how many toys are still left. How many toys would we still have to put on the shelf? Okay? So get ready. We're going to count all together how many toys are still left. Ready, set, count with me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many toys are still left to be put on the shelf?
I think 5.
5. Nice work, Kaylee. So we will write 5 toys still have to go on the shelf over here. Now, being our super duper checker students we are, let's go back, reread the problem, okay? Ready? Now read it with me. Set, read with me. 9, take away 4, equals 5. Yep. There were 9 toys. 4 were put on the shelf. 5 toys were still left. Nice job, okay? Hopefully we're getting used to having to listen carefully to those story problems. Having to carefully draw out to problem solve the problem. To problem solve the story. Okay? Then writing it out carefully, our number sentence to solve the problem. Kaylee and I are going to come back with one more problem for us to practice. We're back with our last problem-solving problem up here, okay? Make sure you're listening carefully to the story problem read, thinking about how you can draw it out to solve it, and write the number sentence, okay? Are you ready for our next story problem?
Yeah.
Okay, it's a fun one, okay?
Yeah.
Let's see. Kaylee has 6 chicken nuggets. Kaylee gives 3 chicken nuggets to her sister. How many chicken nuggets does Kaylee still have? That's about you. Let's see again, okay? Kaylee has 6 chicken nuggets. Kaylee gives 3 chicken nuggets to her sister. How many chicken nuggets does Kaylee still have?
Four.
Well, let's double check, okay? I'm not sure. We gotta definitely draw it out, write the number sentence to solve, okay? So, it started with, Kaylee has six chicken nuggets. How many chicken nuggets does Kaylee start with? Six.
Six.
So how many am I going to draw up here?
Six.
Six. If that's what you're saying at home, yes. Six. Let's go ahead, count together how many I'm putting out, the six, okay? Ready, set, count with me. One, two, three,
four,
five,
six.
Six. Yep. How many chicken nuggets did Kaylee start with?
Six.
Six. So I write that problem here. We start with six chicken nuggets. Okay? Then Kaylee gives three nuggets to her sister. Is Kaylee getting more chicken nuggets? Or is she giving away, having chicken nuggets taken away? Away. So do I write the plus or the minus sign here?
Minus.
Nice job. If that's what you said too, yes. Minus or take away the three chicken nuggets she gives to her sister. Okay? How many chicken nuggets did Kaylee give to her sister?
Three.
Okay, three. So we're going to cross out or X out or say goodbye to three of these chicken nuggets. Get ready to count with me as we X them out, okay? Ready, set, count with me. One,
two,
three. Three chicken nuggets were given to her sister. So what number do I write here? How many did she give away?
Three.
Yes, if that's what you're saying at home, nice job. Three chicken nuggets given away. Six chicken nuggets, take away three chicken nuggets. What sign do we need to write next to show six take away three is? Okay, what's that sign we need to write?
Equals.
Yes, if that's what you said too, good job. Equals. Now we go back and count. How many chicken nuggets does Kaylee still have left? She had six, gave away three, but how many does she still have left? Thank you. Okay. Let's go ahead and count together. Ready, set, count with me. One,
two,
three. How many chicken nuggets does Kaylee still have?
I'd say three.
Three, yes. So, all right, our answer over here, three chicken nuggets left. Now, being the very careful students we are, let's go back, reread our number sentence we wrote, okay? You're going to read it with me. Ready, set, read with me. Six, take away three equals three.
Yes.
Kaylee has six chicken nuggets. She gave away, like take away, three nuggets to her sister. Then that equals that she had three chicken nuggets left for herself. Yay! You've done the problem solving, okay? Hopefully you were becoming more and more comfortable with listening to the story problem, drawing it out or using tools or manipulatives you have at home to do it, and then writing a number sentence to solve it, okay? I hope you'll have an easier time, even easier, when you're doing your learning packet all about it, okay? Have a great rest of your remote learning day. Bye, everyone.
Hey, kids.